Welcome to Chem Help ASAP. One of the most common methods for communicating organic structures is through Lewis dot structures. Let's learn how to draw Lewis dot structures and see how the octet rule is highly relevant to these pictures. On the left of the screen, we have three names of organic molecules: methane, ethanol, and amphetamine. We also have the molecular formula for each molecule. A molecular formula is great for communicating the composition of a molecule, but a molecular formula does not give any useful structural information. In other words, molecular formulas do not tell us how the atoms in the molecule are connected to one another. That's where Lewis dot structures will help. We're going to draw these three loop molecules as Lewis dot structures. As we draw these structures, notice how many bonds and lone pairs are on each of the atoms. These are stable molecules. If we draw the molecules correctly, each atom should satisfy the octet rule and have a combination of four bonds and or lone pairs. Let's start with methane. There isn't much to the structure of methane. The carbon sits in the middle and is bonded to each of the hydrogens. The carbon has four bonds, eight electrons, to satisfy the octet rule. The carbon-hydrogen bonds are shown as lines between the atoms. The hydrogens have one bond each to satisfy the duet rule. Let's move to ethanol, which is only slightly bigger than methane. For ethanol, we'll start with a carbon. The carbon is bonded to three hydrogens and another carbon. That second carbon is bonded to the first carbon, two hydrogens, and the oxygen. The oxygen is bonded to the second carbon and a hydrogen, which is two bonds. The oxygen does not satisfy the octet rule. The oxygen, however, also has two lone pairs of electrons, which we show as two dots for each. Amphetamine is a larger molecule. It contains a large section called a benzene ring, which is connected to the rest of the molecule. I'll draw the benzene ring first as a six-membered ring. I'll then fill in the hydrogens on each carbon as well as show where we have double bonds between some of the carbons. Double bonds are drawn with two lines instead of just one. The carbon in the upper right only has three bonds. That's where we will attach the rest of the molecule to complete the structure of amphetamine. If you're tracking the nine carbons from the molecular formula, the benzene ring has six carbons. The rest of the molecule must have the remaining three. We have a carbon attached to another carbon, attached to yet another carbon. Hydrogens fill out the remaining bonds for carbon except this one. Nitrogen is attached here, and the nitrogen is also attached to two other hydrogens. To complete the octet for nitrogen, we will add a lone pair. Those are our Lewis dot structures for methane, ethanol, and amphetamine. Note that, like we mentioned in the previous video on the octet rule, all the carbons in these molecules have four bonds. The nitrogen has three bonds and a lone pair. The oxygen has two bonds and two lone pairs. The octet rule is very useful for evaluating whether we have likely drawn our Lewis structures in a reasonable manner. Our Lewis dot structures that we have drawn are a simple method for communicating the complexity of a molecule's structure.